In video 4, we created a JavaFX Spring Boot application that shows an empty line chart. In the last video, we wired in a web client stock client to use to connect to the prices service. In this video, we're going to get the line chart to show the real-time prices coming from our Kotlin Spring Boot service. First, we need to create an initialize method, which is called once any FXML fields have been populated. This initialize method will set up where the chart data is going to come from. We need to set the chart data from something. The chart data is a list of series, as the chart could display more than one series of data. Let's create a local variable for this list. We want to add a series to this list. The series object is initialized with a list of the data points that make up the series, which we'll declare as a field in this class. Our data is a pair of string and double. We'll initialize this to an empty list for now, as our chart doesn't have any data to display when it starts. We need to get the data for our chart from somewhere. This is what we added the web client stock client for. We ask the client for prices for a given stock symbol. Let's hard code a value in here for now. Given this is reactive programming, what we need to do now is to subscribe to the flux that is returned from this call. The simplest thing to do here is to subscribe the chart controller itself. At the moment, the chart controller isn't the right type for this. One approach is to make this class implement java.util.function.consumer and have it consume stock prices. We can get IntelliJ IDEA to implement the methods required to fulfill this interface. Now let's think about what we need to do with a stock price when we receive one. We need to add the right values from the stock price to the chart's series data. We want time on the x-axis. Let's use the second value, as this is the simplest way to have the prices tick along. This is an int value, so we should use string.valueOf to make it fit our expected chart type. The y value is going to be the price of the stock. This looks fine, but there's another thing to consider with this programming model. Changing the series data will be reflected by an update in the user interface, which will be drawn by the UI thread. This accept method is running on a different thread, listening to events from the backend service. So we need to tell the UI thread to run this piece of code when it gets a chance. We do this by using the platform.runLater method, passing in a lambda expression of the code to run on the UI thread. Let's see what it looks like now. First, we need to make sure our backend Kotlin Spring Boot service is running. It needs to be emitting prices for our chart to listen to. Once this is running, we can go back to our UI module and run our JavaFX application. We can see that with these very few lines of code, we've created a JavaFX line chart that uses Reactor to listen to a Spring Boot service and update itself in real time. Let's change this label to something more useful. We'll extract the symbol into a local variable. We want to use it in more than one place. We can give the series a label, so let's use the symbol name for that. Now, when we rerun the application, we see the symbol's name here on the label for the series. This code is a little bit unwieldy with all the type information, so we can import series itself to remove the unnecessary XY chart prefix. We can add a static import for observable array list, so we don't need to repeat FX collections everywhere. We can add an import for value of to make this line a little shorter. And we can import the data class to remove another repetition of XY chart. These refactorings shouldn't have changed the behavior of the code, so when we rerun, we'll see everything working the same way as before. So there we have it. A JavaFX application that uses Spring's web client to connect to a Spring Boot service, subscribes to the reactive stream of prices, and draws the prices on a line chart in real time. Thanks for watching.